If you're really going to stick with this better than everyone act, you need to be able to back it up. That being said, we've got an indie wrestler with a PC tryout today, and we really want to test their mettle. If you're such a hot shot, think you can keep them down for 10 seconds?
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, ring the bell.
So, Road Dogg and I were thinking, since apparently you want to stand out so much around here, that we should come up with some new ways to challenge you.
What you have in mind?
One of my favorites is what I'm calling show up or throw up. Basically, you have to do 500 squats and then wrestle Chase without throwing up.
Sounds easy enough. I'm in.
Good. Try your best not to throw up. Road Dogg has a weak stomach, so he'll start blowing chunks too. And it can get ugly real fast.
Yeah.
So, you beat me on day one, albeit under questionable circumstances. But do you think you can take down two Hall of Famers in a tag match?
Are the Bushwhackers in town?
Funny. I mean, how about you team up with anyone here and face me in Road Dogg?
If beating you two helps me get more recognition, then I'll do it.
All right. Figure out who you want to team with, and we'll see you in the ring.
I already know who I want. Paragon J. Pierce.
Break!
Oh.
was in a bit of a philosophical mood last night, and I started to wonder. If you never have a chance to use your finishing move, is it still a finisher? Or is it just a regular old move?
Shocked you're not out with a head injury after thinking that hard. But please, continue.
I guess I was thinking about how dominating my finisher is going to be in the WWE, but you guys are probably never even going to get to use yours. Which is kind of sad. Total waste of some perfectly good finishing moves.
I don't think you have to worry about that, since I guarantee I could hit my finisher on you today.
Really? Okay, well, how about we have a little fatal four-way finisher match? First one to hit theirs wins.
Deal. I look forward to showing you that my finishing move is not gonna go to waste.
Hey, rookie. You have a passport or no?
Yeah. Why?
Turns out I have to go back to Japan to finish out one more match of my contract there. WWE thinks a Japanese opponent might try to injure me for leaving, so unfortunately, I have to face one of you guys. But whatever. At least it will be an easy win. So do you want to make the trip or no?
Don't know how easy it will be for you, but I'll do it. When do we go?
Not so fast. Obviously, this is a huge opportunity, so Hector and Chase want it in too. So you're gonna face them in a triple threat match for the right to lose to me in Japan. Good luck.
Thank you.
Hey, we have some good news. You're not going to have to deal with us much longer. Well, maybe if everything works out.
What do you mean?
Triple H feels like he's seen enough from you and the rest of the class. So it's time for an official evaluation.
Is this the PC showcase you mentioned back on my first day?
Exactly. All of the GMs will be here to see you guys in action. If you impress any of them enough, you might receive a contract offer.
It's about time. I was ready for this after I beat you day one.
I understand the urgency, but some guys never get this kind of opportunity. Don't take it for granted.
Don't worry. I'll make the most of it.
We have the matches for the showcase lined up. Paragon is facing Hector, and you'll be going up against Chase. And don't repeat this, but that should set you up to look good in front of the GMs.
Yeah, about that, Road Dog. See, I was thinking about his first day.
Oh, no. It's never good when you're thinking.
I know. I was thinking about how he called me out and beat me. It was definitely a statement win for sure. But what I'm getting at is, how about instead of taking another shortcut at the showcase, you face me again instead? Beat me once when I wasn't prepared. Can you do it again in a high-stakes situation? This time, when I'm ready.
Just think about this for a second, okay? A win over HBK could open a lot of doors. But that's no easy task. Chase is the safer bet, but definitely wouldn't impress the GMs as much.
I'd be happy to beat you again.
Good. But technically, you have to beat me again twice. It's gonna be a 2 out of 3 falls match.
That's great and all, guys, but now I need to find a new opponent for Chase, and that's gonna turn into a whole thing. Not that that's your problem. Anyway, before I forget, the GMs want the full presentation for the showcase, so you're going to get to wear the gear you designed a while back. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck, kid.
just a heads up, I wouldn't get all worked up about this PC showcase, since the GMs are really only coming to scout me.
That's funny, because I think they're actually showing up to see me.
Who are you even facing anyway? I heard Shawn Michaels?
Yeah, I'm going to beat him again and show the GMs what they've been missing out on.
Are you an idiot? You had the chance to face Chase, which would have been a walk in the park and a guaranteed contract offer. But instead you chose to face a motivated Mr. WrestleMania who's out for revenge?
A win over HBK will punch my ticket to anywhere I want to go in WWE.
Yeah, and a loss will do nothing.
Well, that's why I'm not going to lose.
The fact that you had the courage to not only face a Hall of Famer like Shawn Michaels, but then beat him in a match like that, really proved what kind of competitor you are. That's why I'd like to offer you a SmackDown contract.
This is a big decision, and I need more time to weigh my options.
I get that, but
I've heard a lot about you, and you didn't disappoint with your win over Shawn Michaels today. With that being said, I'd like to offer you the opportunity to sign with NXT.
I look forward to dominating NXT and using it as a stepping stone to bigger things.
A bit pompous, are you? I have a feeling you might be singing a different tune after you see what NXT is all about. In fact, with that attitude, you might become the stone that gets stepped on.
I look forward to proving you wrong.
Hey, I heard you're going to NXT. Looks like I'll have some company.
You signed with NXT too?
Yeah, I just spoke with Regal. I think it's a great fit for my style, and I'll be able to compete for the Cruiserweight Championship. We should look out for each other there.
That's a good idea. Especially considering we might have targets on our backs coming in as the new guys.
Look forward to competing with you there. Congrats, man.
You too.
You're looking at the Blue Brand's newest superstar. It took longer than it should have, but finally, I'm gonna show the WWE Universe what the rest of the world already knows. When it comes to wrestling, I am the paragon.
Good for you. I'm gonna do the same thing in NXT, but without the lame nickname.
Whatever. I'd say I'll be watching you on NXT, but I'll be too busy dominating SmackDown. But if you ever make it out of the minors, let me know.
Heard you got signed. Congrats.
Thanks. What's the matter with you?
What's the matter? You and Hector and Paragon all got signed, but no one wanted me, and now I'm stuck here while you guys are all moving on to bigger and better things.
Did you really think you'd get signed? Wake up, man. You've been the weakling since we started here, and your unrealistic outlook only makes things worse.
You really think that?
Look, I'm not saying you're dead in the water, but consider today a reality check. Three of us were signed and you weren't. If you're ever going to make it, something needs to change, and that's on you.
Maybe it's not me. Maybe someone's trying to hold me back. Or maybe they just didn't like my look. I can change that easy. I do still have that rib costume.
Chase, look in the mirror. It's none of that other stuff. It's you. I gotta go clean out my locker. See you around.
Well, you got the better of me again. I'd like to think it would have been a different story 25 years ago, but who knows?
Yeah, it probably would have, since you'd be wrestling a baby.
I get it. I'm ancient. Look, I heard you're going to NXT. Play your cards right, and I think you're going to do big things there.
Thanks for saying that, especially since we haven't always seen eye to eye.
It's hard for me to see eye to eye with anyone these days. That's a joke. But nonetheless, this is always a proud day for us. Just remember, don't slip up and embarrass me or the other coaches, okay?
So basically, don't do anything you would have done when you were starting out in WWE.
Exactly. Good luck, kid. I'll be watching.
And there you see the newest addition to NXT's roster making their way into the arena.
If you ask me, I think he's going to do big things here.
Well, nobody asks you, but I have to agree. This guy's the definition of superstar.